Hello friends, in this video we are going to see about the comparison of fractions. In the fourth standard we have seen comparison of like fractions. Let us first of all recall about the comparison of like fractions. What is meant by like fractions and how we can compare the like fractions? Well, like fractions means the fractions which are having same denominator. Now we'll see some examples of comparing like fractions. For example, we are going to take a circle. We are going to divide the circle into equal parts, and if I shade two parts of it with the red color, then the fraction of the shaded part will become 2 out of 8. Now if I take another circle of the same size and it is being divided into 8 equal parts, and if I am going to shade 3 parts out of these 8 parts, then the fraction of the shaded part will become 3/8. And by looking at these two figures, these two circles, it's very clear that the fraction 3/8 is greater than 2/8. Here we have shaded 2 parts, here we have shaded 3 parts. So this shaded part of the circle, or this circle, is shaded more as compared to this one. So clearly we can see that 3/8 is greater than 2/8. So comparison of like fractions is easy. We'll take one more example. We'll take a rectangle which is being divided into 10 equal parts. Now, if I shade 4 parts of this rectangle, first rectangle, then the fraction of the shaded portion of the rectangle will be 4/10 parts. Okay, and now in the second rectangle, if I take second rectangle of the same size which is being divided into 10 equal parts, and if I am going to shade 6 parts out of this 10 parts, then the fraction of the shaded portion of rectangle will become 6/10. And very clearly you can see that the shaded portion of this rectangle is more. So 6/10 is actually greater than 4/10. So we can say that 6/10 is greater than 4/10. And you can see that here the denominator of both the fractions is equal. So they are like fractions. They are known as like fractions because the whole, or the rectangle, or the figure is divided into equal number of parts. There are also 10 parts, there are also 10 parts. So comparison of like fractions is very easy. We'll take one more example. We'll take a circular disc which is being divided into 12 equal parts. Now you can see that the 7 parts out of this circle, they are shaded with the red. 2 parts are shaded with the yellow, and 3 parts, they are white in color. So what is the fraction of red in this case? The fraction of the red in this case will be 7/12. Then what is the fraction of yellow? The yellow, you can see that there are 2 parts out of 12 parts. So fraction of yellow is 2/12, and the fraction of white is a 3 part out of 12 parts. So 3/12. And it's very clearly, you can see that the red portion is shaded more, or the red color is there in the shade more. So definitely the fraction of red, which is 7/12, is the greatest. On the second number, the fraction of white will be there, where we have seen 3 parts out of 12 parts. And the fraction of yellow, that is 2 parts out of 12 parts, is the lowest fraction. Here also you can see that the denominators of all these fractions, 7/12, 3/12, and 2/12, is equal. So when the denominator is equal, they are like fractions, and like fractions can be compared very easily. Now we'll take one more example. You will be able to see another circular disc which is being divided into 16 equal parts. 3 parts, they are shaded with yellow. Then 2 parts, they are white. Then again 3 parts with the blue, 2 parts with white, and then 4 parts with the red. Now what is the fraction of yellow? It is 3/16. What is the fraction of blue? It is again 3/16. And you can see that the red shaded portion, which is yellow and blue in color, they are of equal size. So here like fractions we can compare easily, very well. Again, you can see that what is if we go to compare red color and yellow color, the fraction of red and fraction of yellow. Fraction of red is 4/16, and fraction of yellow is 3/16. Very clearly, you can see that the red portion is shaded in more. So definitely, the fraction of red is more, which is 4/16 out of 3/16. So for comparing like fractions, it's very easy because the denominator is equal. We just compare using their numerators. But what about unlike fractions? So if we go to take the examples of two circular discs here, we will take a circular disc which is being divided into 12 equal parts, another circular disc which is being divided into 8 equal parts. And now, if I say compare the fraction of red on this disk, this is 7/12, with the fraction of blue, you can see the fraction of blue is 2 out of 8. Then how to compare? Well, by looking at the figure, you can see that the fraction of red is greater than the fraction of blue, because the blue part is very less over here and the red part is more here. But when I give this problem numerically, how to solve this problem, how to compare unlike fractions, that we'll see in the next video. Till then, goodbye.